Oh, and Nurse Misery. Only suffered internal bleeding, a concussion.
Two fractured ribs. Really, only. I mean, that's not that bad considering.
That's nothing. It's like a mosquito bite.
Yeah, from an explosion of unknown origin. That's the creepy thing.
Random explosion. You could have been dead. Now, sorry for your two cracked ribs.
This explosion, like normally explosions come out, you have some sort of energy release, like a flash.
Right.
Or fire or something.
Nothing like that.
Nothing. There's no fire, no flash, just boom. So even if they say like she was smoking by an oxygen tank, one of them.
Right, but that's a good idea, but where's the rest of the oxygen tank?
It could have shot into the water, but even that going off, you would have some sort of energy that everybody would have noticed. And there would have been enough of an explosion.
Like a burn crater or something.
Yeah, and someone would have felt the impact of this thing blowing up. Well, but no one did.
Chuckles and I had a small, teeny, tiny fire at our day job today, and there was friggin' smoke everywhere. This lady blows up, and there's nothing.
Yeah,
let's say most likely then it was some kind of. Well, we'll go for the rational explanation first. Most likely it was trapped methane, some kind of explodable gas under the sand of the beach. This has been known to happen, especially people that live around swamps.
Methane pockets. You're right.
Yeah, methane pockets. Most likely that's what this was.
And it's possible because where this lady was setting is on the ledge of rocks. So there's a lot of stuff that could have gotten trapped under
there. So she wasn't on like that flat beach sand.
No, she was right by those rock pavilions. So
there could have been rotting kale and kelp. Rotting
fish, rotting organics.
Boom. Yeah. And it went.
Then I think I think we came to the solution to the mystery. Methane gas ignited accidentally from rotting organic material of whatever kind.
Came to the top, dealt with the sun, which was already baking that sand, and the two combinations,
it was pretty hot that day.
Kabang. We've all stepped on the beach where that sand is like extremely hot.
Wait, or this beach chair probably, if it had metal legs, just like hit the rocks, made a spark and bang.
Yeah.
Rotting, that too. Rotting kale. You're on a diet. Isn't that what you had for supper tonight?
No, I can't pronounce what we had for supper tonight because we don't have permission, but it was really good.
All right, before we go to the next segment, let's go back to the music for a second. We'll go back to one of Tony Jones's, favorite. What's the word for this, Tony? A mullet man?
Mullet.
Yeah, let's go a little Thin Lizzy here on the Haunted Cabaret. Emerald on Rhode Island Free Radio.
Down from the glen came the marching men with their shields and their swords to fight the fight they believed to be right, overthrow the overlords. To the towns where there was plenty, they brought plunder, swords, and flame. When they left, the town was empty. Children would never play again. Near the border, there were many born to die. Then onward over the mountain, outward towards the sea. They come to claim the emerald. Without it, they could not leave. We'll be right back.
All right, that was Thin Lizzy here on the Haunted Cabaret. And during that music break, you know, I think we started off the show in, you know, pretty good style. You know, with the exploding woman, we solved that mystery with the organic methane explosion. That is the explanation as far as I'm concerned. And
that's the logical one.
Yeah, and I think that takes care of that one right there.
The illogical one is Salty did it.
Yes. Sticking with the illogic is during the music, you two informed me that someone over our patriotic 4th of July weekend basically was killed by setting fireworks off from his head.
Now, I'm no genius, and, well, a lot of us in this room have done some really stupid things.
Absolutely stupid.
But that takes the flipping cake on dumb. I mean, that is gunpowder on top of your flipping head there.
Yeah, I mean, what did he think was going to happen?
I mean, even if you knew it was half dead, why would you still put that on your skull?
All right, here's the answer. He was 22 and drinking.
Oh. Well, he's still stupid.
He's still stupid. I mean, all of us in this room and at this table have drunk.
At the age of 22 and did stupid things. But right, we're all still alive.
Yeah, but we still never put fireworks on the top of our heads.
Why don't you just play Russian roulette and play it with like all six bullets inside there? I mean, as dumb.
Now I will own up. I'll own up right now in the spirit of the holiday just passed. The stupidest thing I ever did on the 4th of July. Okay. Now you know that when you go to see a fireworks show, usually they choose some kind of like the fireworks are launched either from a barge out on the water. Or, you know, a hillside in a park, or, you know, a spot removed from the audience, you know, so you can shoot the rockets and the audience can watch those rockets explode in the red glare in perfect safety. Oh, one 4th of July, I think it was one of the church festivals, they decided to shoot the rockets off from Nunakonkenet Hill that's the borderland of Providence and Johnston, Rhode Island. And so, you know, they secluded themselves up on the hill and started the show. For some reason, now I'm not sure what we had been drinking or otherwise imbibing that day, but my cousins, I forget which cousin, one of my cousins it was, either the one that used a lot of LSD or the one that used a lot of heroin in those days. I'm not quite sure which it was. But one of them suggested, hey, you know what the best way to see these fireworks would be? Let's climb up on the hill and lay down on our backs, and we can see a perfect view of the. We'll see a perfect view, man, of the whole show.
Only for a second, and then right down in your eyes, then you're not seeing a perfect view at all.
Almost dead air. Yes, because now there were four supposedly educated people in this expedition, maybe five. I'm not sure. I think the fifth person might have been a stoner that didn't count. He wouldn't have been counted on for a rational opinion.
Why, Touré?
But be that as it may, all four or five of us thought that this was just a nifty, keen idea. So we snuck through the barricades, went up on Nunakonkenet Hill to within maybe 20 or 30 feet of where they were shooting the rockets, laid down in the tall grass so that they couldn't see us.
Well, that's even worse.
And it gets better and better. Oh, yes.
Wow.
Tall grass, broken bottles, and probably
syringe needles.
Syringes, probably condoms.
This dead is very, bodies.
This is a very very popular hill.
Tetanus and STDs.
We came close to not having to worry about any of those things. Because we found out really quick that when those rockets explode, you know, a couple of hundred feet up in the I don't know, how high do they go?
Pretty high.
What goes up?
It's come down.
Need I say more? And I guess in our altered states, we were under the impression that when those rockets explode up there, that they vaporize.
Gotcha. No flaming shrapnel of death.
I'm here to tell you that there's a lot left of those canisters when they achieve reentry. Yeah.
That takes the cake. That's definitely up there.
I mean,
That doesn't take the cake over the guy lighting off his head.
Oh,
though.
No. I meant he wins for the room, as far as I know.
Now, if you ever want to see someone move quickly, a fireworks story here for the Haunted Cabaret, let's just say this was happening down at Navy Days, and the barge was out a little bit, but not further enough. Mm-hmm. And a similar story where the shrapnel was raining down.
Right.
If you want to see an old crap moment, see what happens when the shrapnel rains down on a cannon's gunpowder box. You want to see how fast people move? I had never seen this happen in my life. And these are all guys that are in their 50s and 60s. The minute this stuff rained down, all I heard was, pack those in boxes, and they ran. And then whose idea was this to say, hey, let's put the cannons over here, which have more gunpowder in it than that barge, and rounds?
Well, you know what? This makes me possibly feel a little less stupid on behalf of myself and my cousins.
Right, and this was an educate.
Here's another group of people. Right? It never occurred to that those rockets, once, you know, in other words, I think a lot of people, if you really ask them, what happens to the fireworks after they explode?
They're left.
Right. They vape, you know, there's pretty lights and they're gone.
And these guys should know better. They're in the artillery. They know that stuff doesn't vaporize. But I don't think they realized how close that barge was.
Plus, wasn't it windy and they weren't quite accounting for all of the elements?
I had never seen these elderly folks move so quickly in their life. I'm like,
a lot of beer bellies run.
Well, I'll tell you, then it's a wonder that the United States did as well as it did fighting in Korea. If these artillerymen don't know how to allow for, you know,
the worst part of this. How did this get by not one military group? The Coast Guard said it was okay, and the Navy lit these off in front of their area.
Active military, so, along with militia, who are also ex-veterans.
It
and all
slipped
of
by three quote-unquote professional military groups.
Well, maybe maybe it was an example of rivalry between military organizations.
Coast Guard's like, I don't care if you blow yourselves up.
We're
have
out
fun.
On the water, yeah, we're
if,
fine.
Right, Navy's if Army wants to be this stupid, Navy's going to let it happen. Or whatever the case might have
but
been.
But the worst part is this was so close to the Navy College. And within,
the students could have been taking notes.
You want a nightmare. Now, it didn't register in the civilian's head what was going on, because 100 yards away from this cannon tape were a bunch of people on blankets. And they just pulled what the guy did at the beach. They sat there and said, I'm not moving. Now, if that had gone off, they would have gotten a front row seat to those explosions.
Yeah, they would have been up there.